Welcome to the last Mailbag Monday of 2019. It's been a fun year. Let's get busy opening stuff. And the first thing to open is Robbie Scotch Ale from Farmery Estate Brewing in Neepawa, Manitoba. I've tried a few of their beers. This is one of the ones that I don't mind. I've had it a few times. And they've also got a stout, which is pretty good. Apparently, all the ingredients that they use are grown right on their farm in Neepawa, which is pretty cool too. Yep, nice beer. What do we have here? We have LED module. Okay, that should be fun. Oh, come on, get out. So this is a set of six little LEDs with resistors mounted on a little board that is designed to go onto an Uno, just to go directly on. Yeah, so it picks up the ground, and then these six digital pins here. And that's just for convenient prototyping, basically, rather than, you know, stuffing a bunch of LEDs in breadboards and putting a bunch of jumper wires and stuff on. You can just do something like this. 6-bit multicolor LED module board, DC 3-12 volts for Arduino Due Uno Mega 2560 and Mega. I got this for $1.48 from Windeal. Okay, I don't know if I bought from them before. Much to say down there, 7 pins, 6 bits, 1K limiting resistor, voltage 3.3 to 12 volts. Right. Okay, so just pulled out a few random boards here. So it's obviously not going to work on a Nano or a Pro Micro or something like that directly, because unless you've put female headers on it, but that's not a normal thing to do. But if you plug it into a breadboard, the pins are in the right order from ground through a bunch of digital outputs to plug it in like that. It's kind of ginchy and awkward, but I think it might work just temporarily. But that's not really what it's designed for. It's designed for boards of this shape. So on the Mega, could put it over there on 8 through 13 and ground, just like that. The other place where there's ground at the end of a row is over here. From, what is that, 43 to 50, 43, 45, 47, 49, 51, 53, and ground. That obscures some pins, but again, if you're just tinkering and you just want some quick LEDs, that'll work there. But of course, what it's best at is right there, pins 8 through 13 on an Uno. And I've got just a quick little sketch that I knocked together to demonstrate how it works. That's all it is. Just an LED board. But at least we know this one works. Why is that last LED not lighting? Oh, no, because I'm an idiot. I plugged it in wrong. It goes this way. There we go. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Right. And that comes on at the same time as the built-in one. Yeah. Next thing in, module. Yay. Bunch of TO220 devices. The last time I thought these were power transistors, they turned out to be regulators. These are TIP-122. Sounds very much like a transistor part number. 10 pieces TIP-122 TO220 transistor, complementary NPN, 100 volt, 5 amp, new good quality T3. I got these from GC Supermarket for their princely sum of $1.43. 14 cents a transistor? Yeah, I can do that. Okay, TIP-122, 100 volts, collector current, 5 amps. Yeah. Darlington 5 amp power transistor. Okay. It's got a whole family of them and the corresponding PNPs as well, which I didn't grab, I guess. I'm I don't know. I'm just more comfortable with NPN if I need just a single transistor for something. Not sure why. I've got PNPs in stock. So, yeah. Plastic PCB modules times two. Ooh. Safety package in pink for your protection. Where have we seen these before? Good thing I didn't let that Arduino get too far away. Let's see if these ones work, especially if I plug them in the right way around. Oh, these ones are blue. Well, that's cute. Does the other one work too? I'm sure it does. There's not much to go wrong on them. Except for some idiot plugging them in backwards. Yeah, that looks good. Alrighty then. Arduino Display Kit 6-bit blue LED module board for Uno, Mega, AVR, etc. Yeah, I got these ones from Canton Electric. They're $130 each. I bought two of them, so $260. The red ones were $1.48. These ones are $1.30. Strange. Usually blue LEDs are cost a little bit more money. Oh well, whatever. Next in we have modules. A kit! Lee Shop is the seller. Okay. What does this look like? Oh, okay. Oh! Is this another one of those waveform generator kits? Is it different from the one that I already got? Not really. Different brand. Why did I do that? Anyway, I guess we know what this does. I see 8038. Yeah, that seemed familiar. Yeah, that's exactly the same. Okay. So did I have a brain fart or... Actually, no, that one I don't think was... all that awesome. No? Or was that the good one? No, this was the one that gave me cleaner outputs. I think there was some suspicion that other one was a dud or was producing some really bogus waveforms. Yeah, I think that was it. So I said that's what it was. Yeah, I decided to grab a second one because I mean they're cheap and just give it another shot to see if I just had some bad components in that one or whatnot. And it's cheaper to buy the kit than it is to buy just a few components and do it that way. Such is the wonders of cheap Chinese electronics. DC 12 to 24 volt ICL 8038 DSS signal generator IC DIY sine square triangle wave ass. Right. From Superstar. This just gets weirder and weirder. Currently, they're selling it for $2.28 Canadian. I got it, back when I got it was $2.17. So it's an open collector output, so it needs a load resistor. Could that be what I was doing wrong? I'm going to have to think about this. Anyways, 50 to 5 kilohertz, switchable in two bands. But they do have a version... They do a couple of different versions that can go up to 300 or 450 kilohertz. Before I make this one, I should check the frequencies of the other one and build this one with slightly different frequencies too. And I have to remember to put a load resistance on it when I'm testing it too. And the last thing... in, what does it say? I can't even read it. Heating core. Oh, that's ceramic heating oils for one of them's broken. You gotta be fucking kidding me. Four of them are okay, one of them's broken in the package. So, the reason I ordered these was... because back when I bought this thing, shortly after I ordered a spare handle with cable and tip and element and everything just to have on hand just in case something went wrong. And when I tested them, this one was a lot slower to heat up than this one. I wasn't quite sure why, but a while ago I got curious and took it apart. I should have taken the tip off first. And discovered that its element was cracked right from day one. So I'm guessing that probably has something to do with it. So I ordered this package of 5 replacement elements, and one of them showed up broken. I hope they were cheap.
5 pieces soldering iron station replace heating element ceramic heater core for $936. Apparently that's Heiko's part number. I got this from Yaffy Top. They've got it on sale for a little while here. I paid $579, that's the regular price. They just got it on sale for a day or so. What is that? Buck and change each. I'm not thrilled at getting one broken, but I'm also not too up in arms about it. Oh, I mean, it's annoying, but you know, 24-volt, 50-watt, 4-wire nickel coated heating wire. 4-wire, yeah. So 2 wires are the heating element and 2 wires are the temperature sensor, which goes back to the soldering station to tell it what's going on.
So how do I get at that? Is it just this? Oh yeah, that string is not providing very much relief at all. Okay. So I just have to solder those 4 wires onto there. Okay, that shouldn't be too ugly, I guess, to do. Ew, that piece is broken off too. This stuff takes a fairly rough handling on its way on the slow boat from China, doesn't it? And there's the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Interesting stuff. These are going to be handy, I think, just when I'm prototyping, tinkering with Arduinos. What do I got here? The blue ones. The 2 blue ones took a month to get here. The red one took 3 weeks to get here. Oh, okay. So it's the winner so far. The power transistors took a month. The signal generator kit took 6 weeks. I'm going to have to compare that against the other one when I'm building it, I guess. And the soldering iron ceramic heaters, not only did they show up with one of them broken, they took 3 bloody months to get here. Wow. Oh, well, I got 4 good ones anyways. I shouldn't have any issues running out and burning them out. And actually, in the, 2 years, a year and a half that I've had this one, as a cheap fake Heiko 601, it's done well. It hasn't burned out. I haven't had any real troubles with it. But I got some spare parts just in case. Yeah, so, thanks for watching. As usual, I really appreciate that. Thanks to my Patreon supporters for helping me keep my shop stocked with things to play with. And, of course, buying me a beer now and again. I appreciate that, guys. Thank you. Comments, questions, complaints, concerns, all that down in the comments section below. I will talk to you, I guess, in January. Thanks. Bye.